everyone. In the last lecture, we have talked about how to use predicate logic to represent knowledge. Today, we'll be exploring this particular knowledge and reasoning thing using for this particular topic, that is representing knowledge using rules. So, let's start today's lecture. So, the topic is representing knowledge using rules. So, let us have some introductory talk. So, we are going to represent the knowledge. So, what is the general problem in computer science? That is, how to efficiently represent that knowledge. In the computer science domain, so far you have understood to represent the knowledge using data structures. You have written the codes for queue, linked list, arrays, words, records, list. So far I think you have already done. That was how to represent the knowledge, that is in the form of data structure, that you have done so far. But for the artificial intelligence domain, that is some more specific problems will be given to you. So there, the knowledge is needed to be represented using knowledge structures. So those can be lists, trees, procedural representations, logic and predicate calculus, rules, semantic nets and frames, and then clips. Those are different ways of representing knowledge in AI. One particular example that we are going to talk about in the next lecture, that is on the how to represent knowledge using semantic net. So these are the different ways of representing the knowledge in artificial intelligence domain. Now, what are the different kinds of knowledge that are available? So, these are the objects. So, you have already, I think you have already listened to the last lecture, that is on the predicate logic. There is a concept of objects. So, objects, that is the description and the classifications of the objects, that are the knowledge. Now, there is another kind of knowledge, is the events, that is the time sequence. So, suppose in the vacuum cleaner world problem, if this vacuum cleaner goes to room number, suppose A, and does the action of cleaning. So, what will be the outcome? The outcome will be room will be clean. That is the cause and effect. Now, the vacuum cleaner has moved to room number A, and after cleaning the room A, it moves to the room number B. That is where the time sequence has been given. That is, suppose at 9 o'clock, the vacuum cleaner will be at room number A, and it will take around suppose 30 minutes. So, at 9:30, the vacuum cleaner will be in the room number B, then it will be cleaned. So, that is the time sequence. And what will be the cause and effect? That is, if it's clean, does the clean up function, that means dirt will be removed. Those are the cause and effect. Now, in this knowledge domain, another type of is that is the relationship. So, what are the relationship? You have already studied in the last class. That is the, suppose John is the father of Mary. So, that is the relationship among objects. Now, there can be the relationship between objects and events. So, those are the different kinds of relationships available. Another most important or another interesting thing is that is the meta-knowledge. So, you can be given with different sorts of knowledge. Knowledge will be of different form, and there can be sometimes redundant information given to you. That is more number of information, that information is not required to you. That is the extra information. You need to remove that extra information. So, that is an acquiring the information that is needed to you. That is known as the meta-knowledge. That is knowledge within knowledge. That is the meta-knowledge. Now, how to distinguish between knowledge and its representation? That is, here mappings are not one-to-one and it never get it complete or exactly right. So, these are the ways of representing or different parameters for the knowledge in the knowledge domain. So, this knowledge can be segregated into different types. One type of segregation can be that is known as a priori knowledge and a posteriori knowledge. So, a priori. So, as the name suggests, so that means the knowledge must have come before doing something. That is a priority. We have prior information, right? We used to say that, we have to suppose board a train. So what prior information you can have, that is what is the timetable of the train. That is the, suppose the train runs from station A at 10 o'clock. So that is the prior information you have. So that you will be reaching, so you must reach the station at suppose 9:50 to smoothly board the train. So that is the priority knowledge, that you should have certain knowledge that is doing anything. So that is the knowledge that comes from before perceiving through the senses. So that is the, that is, there will be sensors in the agents. So before sensing, the knowledge that is available to the agent, that is the a priori knowledge. And this particular knowledge is considered to be universally true. Okay. Another type of knowledge is that a posteriori knowledge. So this type of knowledge is verifiable through the senses. So what is that? Suppose after reaching the station, you found that the train is not at 10 o'clock, it is at 10:05. So that is 5 minutes late, or where it can be due to the late schedule of the train running, or it can be due to the change in the timetable. So those can be the another type of knowledge, that is a posteriori knowledge. So this type of knowledge will be, you are going to gain that knowledge after verifying through the senses. So after the sensors are going to sense something, then the knowledge will be verifiable, and that will be known as a posteriori knowledge. And this type of knowledge may not always be reliable. Why not reliable? As there can be errors in the sensors. So that is that it's not always reliable. Okay. Another type of segregation can be there. That is the procedural knowledge and declarative knowledge. So as the name suggests, that is a procedural. That is from the word procedure. Procedure is what? That is knowing how to do something. That is the procedure. That this needs to be done, this needs to be done. So that is the procedure. How we are going to do it. That is a procedural knowledge. Another type of knowledge is the declarative. That is a declaration. So what is the knowledge? That is the knowing that something is true or false. That is the declarative knowledge. That is from the word declaration. Another type of knowledge is tacit knowledge. That is knowledge not easily expressed by language. That type of knowledge, that is you have certain knowledge, it might sometime have arise that type of situation that you have certain knowledge, but you are not able to express it through the language properly or easily. That is the this type of knowledge. So these are the different kinds of types of knowledge. So in the last class, we have talked about care. So what is care? That is the knowledge representation. So what are the characteristics of a good care? That is knowledge representation. That is the care that it should be able to represent the knowledge important to the problem. It should reflect the structure of knowledge in the domain. Otherwise, our development is a constant process of distorting things to make them fit. Right, that is properly representation, that is we are talking about. It should capture knowledge at the appropriate level of granularity, right, and it should support incremental and iterative development. Now what should not be there? That the care should not be too difficult to reason about. It should not require that more knowledge be represented than is needed to solve the problem. That is, we have talked about, that is the meta-knowledge, that is knowledge within knowledge. So, there will be certain information that will be redundant to you, that is the more knowledge. So, if that is more knowledge is present to you, then it will be, you will be making the system too complex. So, then overfitting can happen. So, that is the more knowledge should not be there. There is sufficient knowledge should be there. Right? That is the characteristics of good care. Now, the structured knowledge represents, modeling-based representation reflect the structure of the domain. And then, reason based on the model. What are the examples? We have already talked about semantic nets, frames, and script. This type of knowledge sometimes called associative networks. Okay, these are that structured knowledge representation. Now, another type of network that is known as associative networks. So just have a very brief introduction about the associative networks. That these type of networks include concepts, various kinds of links between concepts, that is hashpart or aggregation, ESA or specialization, more specialized depending on domain. And that typically also include inheritance. What is inheritance? That we'll be talking about when we'll go into the deeper of the semantic net. And they should also typically include some kind of procedural attachment. So these are the basics of associative networks. Now, we are talking about knowledge representation. So what you are going to do later on, that is, we are going to draw some inference. So that inference has been drawn from the forward chaining or reasoning. That is, starts with available data and uses inference rules to extract more data, that is, from an end user, for example, until a goal is reached. This is the forward chaining. So what is that? You have certain information available to you and you are doing the inference rules. You are using the inference rules and extracting more data. Until what amount of time? Until the goal is reached. So you will be starting from one point and your aim is to reach the goal. That is the forward chaining or reasoning. Another type of thing is that is the backward chaining or reasoning. So backward, so that means we will be starting from the goal and you will be moving towards the source basically. So that is the starts with a list of goals or hypothesis and works backwards from the consequent to the antecedent to see if any data supports any of these consequences. So what is the consequent and antecedent? It has already been discussed in the last classes. So if you do not recapitulate, let us just have another time this recapitulation lesson. Suppose it's like P, then Q. That was the thing. So that is, if P is true, then Q will be true. Something like we have talked about that in the predicate logic, that if it is in the month of July, it will rain. So that is the month of July, that will be the P. Then it rains, that is the Q. So that is the if P, then Q. So here is the antecedent. P is the antecedent, Q is the consequent. That is the consequent. As the name suggests, antecedent and consequent. P is the antecedent, Q is the consequent. So it is backward reasoning. So backward reasoning means from consequent to antecedent. So that is, from Q will be moving towards the P. That is the thing, right? So these are the backward reasoning or chaining. Now, in the next lecture, we will be talked about semantic names. So thank you so much for this listening to the lecture, and happy studying.